Hello viewers and my dear students, welcome to session 4 on application of straight lines. We have already started with one problem in session 3. We'll continue that problem in this session. The problem was this: there are 3 vertical poles and all that. There are 3 vertical poles A, B, C, D and E, F, respectively 2, 4 and 8 meter long. Their ends BDF on the ground and form the corners of an equilateral triangle 5 meter long sides. Determine graphically the distances between the top ends of the poles, namely AC, CE and AE, and take a scale of 1 meter. Also, find the inclination of this with the ground and all that. Okay. Anyway, we'll do everything here. Okay. And this I have explained already. But anyway, it's just a revision. Okay. Since these are all very important from the examination point of view, I really wanted to repeat this. Okay, 3 is here. This is VP, vertical plane, are considered to be wall sometimes. Okay, and this is horizontal plane, considered to be a ground so many number of times. Now you see here, if this is HP, there are 3 poles A, B, C, D, and E, F. Capital A, B, capital C, D, capital E, F are the 3 poles, vertical poles. Okay, measuring A, B 2 meter, measuring CD measuring 4 meter, EF measuring 8 meters. Okay, and you know very well, as per the problem they have given, these 3 poles form the vertices of an equilateral triangle 5 meter long sides. Okay, that means I have drawn 5 meter here. Can you observe 5 meter here at the vertices? No, here, here and here I have drawn the 3 poles. One is AB, one is CD, one is EF. Okay, first you actually try to draw a triangle of 5 meter long sides, and here, here and here you draw the pole. Now here, as you are aware, when you look from the top, AB, this pole and this pole all form a point in the top view. That means when you are looking from the top, A can be seen, B cannot be seen, A bracket B, C can be seen, D cannot be seen, C bracket D, E can be seen, F cannot be seen, E bracket F. They are the top views of these poles, correct, no? And compulsorily, as per the problem, you see that B is on the ground level. B should be touching the ground, D should be touching the ground, F should be touching the ground. Okay, that means they should be on the ground level. Then A, E, C are nearer to observer. Okay, now once you draw this top view, when you look from the front, no? The vertical pole AB, vertical pole CD, vertical pole EF, all will be parallel to VP. As a result, they will be seen in its true length as 2 meter, 4 meter, 8 meter only in the front view. Okay, that means they will be seen in its true length in the front view. Okay, now I think you understood. The poles have written AB, CD, EF, and what you have to write directly in the exam. These things you don't have to show. I have shown you only to make you understand how exactly the poles are situated on the ground and all that. Okay. How to do it in the exam, I tell you. Now you should know here, when you are looking from the top, these 3 vertical poles will be seen as points at the vertices of an equilateral triangle. Okay. And in the front view, this is A dash, B dash, C dash, A dash, B dash, C dash, D dash, E dash, F dash. AB measuring 2 meters, CD measuring 4 meters, EF measuring 8 meters, what I have given here. Okay. Now this, you see here. Now you start like that, XY line, VP, HP, draw one triangle of 50 mm. Because the size, scale adopted here is, scale adopted here is 1 meter is equal to 1 centimeter. Here scale adopted is 1 meter is 10 mm or 1 meter is 10 mm means 1 meter is 1 centimeter. Okay, in that way, or 1 is to 100. When it is 1 is to 100, you are taking 5 meter as, this is 5 meters, this is 5 meters, this is 5 meters. Start on equilateral triangle 5 meters. Since 1 meter is 1 centimeter, you draw 50 mm, 50 mm, 50 mm. Compulsorily you draw A bracket B, C bracket D, E bracket F. This is the top view. This is how you start. XY line, VP, HP, draw one triangle, A bracket B, C bracket D, E bracket F. Okay. Then, draw the corresponding front view. Take the projector. A dash, B dash should be 20 mm, 2 meters. because 1:100. 1 meter is 1 centimeter. Okay, in that way, this is 20 mm or 2 centimeters. Okay, A dash, B dash, C dash, D dash is 40 mm or 4 centimeters. E dash, F dash is 80 mm or 8 centimeters. The top view is completed and front view is completed. What they have given is, for you, find the distance between the top ends of the poles. True distance between the top ends of the poles. A dash, C dash, C dash, E dash, and E dash, A dash. This true distance between the top ends of the poles are to be known. And hope you know, they have clearly given, ends BDF should be on the ground. That's why I see that B dash, D dash, and F dash are on the ground level. Anyway, now what I'll do, I want the true length between E and C, C and E and A. That is why, since I've already drawn AC, CE, AE and the top view, front view I've not drawn, I'll draw it now. AC, CE and EA I've drawn. Okay. Now, did you follow this? Top view is over, front view is over. The requirement is true length of AC. AC, you see, if you observe, A dash, C dash, it is inclined to HP, inclined to VP also. In that way, you can't get the true length either in the front view or top view. Unless you rotate, you can't get the true length. In the same way, C dash, E dash is C dash, D dash is the front view, C is the top view. Okay. And this is also inclined to VP and HP. Unless you rotate, you won't get the true length because C dash, E dash is inclined to HP, C is inclined to VP. In that way, you can't get the true length unless you rotate this and get the true length. But only thing what you observe here is, can you see AE? That is why I have taken the triangle in this position. You could have taken the triangle in any other position. But at least if you take this position, AE, the top ends between A and D, that is between A and D, no? The top end of the pole AB, top end of the pole EF, that is E and A. This is parallel to VP. Then whatever measurement you get here, whatever length you get, that will be directly the true length and corresponding inclinations also. Okay. Now, once you do this, you see here. Carefully you watch here. See here, the scale is 1 meter is equal to 1 centimeter at 10 mm. See here. Now, you see. First, let us say, I have drawn the front view, top view. And this is final thing. This is what you are supposed to show in the examination to get 100% marks. They won't even deduct if you show this type of clarity. Okay. What you do know, I want the true length of AC. Okay. I want the true length of AC. Okay. AC. You see, because I'm getting the true length in the front view because they have asked what exactly is the true length between A and C and also the inclination with the ground only. Inclination with the ground means HP. That means this inclination is also important. That is why I'll rotate in the top view. You could have rotated in the front view, in which case I would have got the inclination with VP. But true length won't vary. But anyway, that is why I have rotated in the top view only to have inclination of the true length with the HP also. Anyway, you'll know now. Okay, CA. Okay, A dash, C dash, AC. It has to be rotated. Okay, no? With C is the fixed point. A as the moving point, I'll rotate it parallel to XY line, A1. Okay, I have moved it parallel to XY line. C is the fixed point, A is the moving point, I have rotated parallel to XY line. Then, A is the moving point, no? That is why, from A you get the locus. From A you get the, you draw a locus line, thin line, and dash against this, and measure C dash, A1 dash. This will be the true length, actual length between A and C. If you measure this, true length of CA or C dash, A1 dash is 54 mm. This length, if you measure, it is 54 mm. Since it is 1 meter is 1 centimeter, you directly call it as 54 mm, no? It is 5.4 centimeter or 5.4 meters. And inclination with the ground is 22 degree. This is what is very important. This you show it, you will never lose even half a mark also. Did you follow? Inclination of the ground also you measure 22 degrees. In the same way, okay, you see here, you have to measure true length of CE also. True length of CE if you want to measure, C dash, E dash and CE both inclined to, this is inclined to HP, this is inclined to VP. That means this is a line inclined to both HP, VP. That means you should know that in the application problem, we are managing three lines without our knowledge. And we are finding so many interesting observations. Okay. Now, C dash, E dash, and this is CE. Okay. This is front view, this is top view. Unless you rotate, you won't get the total. Now, I have C as center, E as CE as radius I have drawn. That means C is a fixed point. E is a moving point. Can you follow? E is a moving point. You rotate it and go up. Since E is a moving point, get the locus from here and dash against this. Then C dash, even dash, you measure. This is true length of CA, okay, which is, that is C dash, even dash. That is 64 mm you get. 64 mm means, don't put it just like the 64 mm because this problem is given in meters and all that. As a result, you should put finally in meters. Since the scale chosen is 1 meter is 1 centimeter, 64 mm is same as 6.4 centimeters, and finally put the answer as 6.4 meters. And inclination with the ground also you measure, 39 degrees you should get. If you have done correctly, everyone should get the same answer, 39 degrees. That means this is also over. Then finally you see here, true length of CA is over, true length of CE is over, and the only thing is true length of AE is remaining. And as I told you earlier, AE is already parallel to VP. As a result, A dash E dash is already in true length. That is why measure A dash E dash, which is already in true length. That is true length of AE, that is A dash E dash, is 78 mm or 7.8 meters. Inclination with the ground is 50 degree. In that way, you are able to complete this problem without any difficulty. Okay. Did you follow this? I think it's clear that a complicated problem has been made very simple here. Now, did you follow here? Now, I'll just revise in 2 minutes. There are three vertical poles, A, B, C, D, E, F. Vertical poles means when they are vertical, top views of these poles will be seen as points. That is AB, C bracket D, E bracket F. They form the vertices of an equilateral triangle, 5 meter long sides. 5 meter means 50 mm or 5 centimeter. Then A bracket B, C bracket D, E bracket F. This is how you start. Then immediately take the corresponding front view. A dash, B dash is the front view of first pole, 20 meter or 2 meter. C dash, D dash is the front view of second pole, that is 4 meters, 40 mm. Then E dash, F dash is the front view of third pole, which is 80 mm or 8 meters. Okay. And you know very well, since they are vertical poles, they are parallel to VP. As a result, they are seen in its actual length here only, in the front view. Okay. Once you draw, join A dash, C dash, C dash, E dash, E dash, A dash. And you are interested in true length between A and C, C and E, and E and A. That is why what I have done is, with C as center, C as radius, I have drawn an arc parallel to XY line. In this position, it is parallel to VP, true length is seen in the front view. That is, C is a fixed point, A is a moving point. That is why A here, no? From here you take a locus, A1 dash, C dash, A1 dash, this is the true length of CA. And the corresponding inclination with the ground or HP is 22 degree. That is one answer. In the same way, CE also you measure. C is the fixed point, E is the moving point, CE you rotate it parallel to XY line, and C is a fixed point, E is the moving point. No? You draw the locus here, draw C as center, E as radius, CE as radius, draw the radius parallel to XY line, that is rotate parallel to XY line, and dash against XY line, dash against the locus. C dash, even dash is the true length of CE, that is 64 mm or 6.4 meters or 39 degree. This is true length already because it is parallel to XY line. 78 mm, 7.8 meters. This is how you are completing the completing this vertical vertical pole problem, which is important from the examination point of view. And we have come to the end of session 4. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you, friends. We'll continue in session 5.